any chance of making friends. Doctors advise the most important thing for Glenn is to rest. Therefore, his family have reiterated the request for their privacy to be respected during this period. And of course, Glenn, we are right behind you in your recovery. It puts broadcasting and football in perspective, doesn't it? But we will be back with you at 4 o'clock today for the second Betfred Cup semi-final between Aberdeen and Rangers. But for now, to meet on Murrayfield for Hearts against Celtic. Let's join Ailey Barrett.
Here at Murrayfield, echo those words from Daryl. It is football that's taking centre stage here at the home of Scottish rugby. Over 60,000 supporters expected in here today. The atmosphere should be electric. The pitch is looking fantastic. Exactly the same dimensions and grass here as at Hamilton. By the time we go back to Daryl at the National Stadium, we will know one of the teams who will be fighting it out for this in December. Let the battle commence.
The holders of the candle, with the home of Scottish rugby on each side, looking to chop the magnificent set of the best of the team. The journey for half of the glory is short, but they'll feel a long way from the final. Can they take a step closer to the first long of success in the world? Who will be the first to get over the line? The final football blows on Greeky. Another will be held in Glasgow Celtic. Fresh lines of the dawn. Pink building high. The dawns are no strangers to hire. And this comes for already their own success in over 10 decades. But they face the team with more success in this competition than any other. This will be the top of the world. And Stephen Gerrard get them over the line and back to Hamden for a cup final. But with which two teams will be left standing either side of it?
It's a Betfred Cup sensational semi-final Sunday on BT Sport today. Later we'll be at Hamden, where it's Rangers against Aberdeen. Kickoff is at 4:30. But first, Celtic are aiming for a 7th successive trophy under Brendan Rodgers, leaving at Hearts looking for a second win over the champions this season. Kickoff at 1:30. Well, what a day we have. As leader Big Bench alongside, delighted to have Hearts captain Christoph Ferrer, Scott McDonald, and a couple of familiar faces on the end there as well. Christoph, literally cold here, but what a perfect day it is for a game of football. And a really, really exciting one.
Yes, a great occasion, a great stadium. It's going to be full to the 60,000 fans here in Detroit. It's going to be a great occasion. And all the boys are thoroughly looking forward to it.
We would love to have been out there as well. You were part of that Hearts team that beat Celtic earlier this season. That's just added a little bit of extra spice to things.
Yeah, you know, I think Celtic have not had a great record going through Jethro recently. And then, you know, it's another chance for us to prove it out as well. And,
It was a
nice little back jogging now, so I'm taking the days down to hopefully be back sooner rather than later.
Yeah, wish you all the best.
But
Scott, I mean, this one, you don't really build this one up, do you?
No, you don't. Two teams, obviously, we're hitting a little bit of form in the last couple of weeks, obviously disappointing again on Thursday in Europe, but they bounced back. It makes it a cracking contest today. You know, Hearts are in fine form as well. They've had a lot of injuries as well, but they just keep going and going. So, all in all, I'm really looking forward to this one. It should be great.
Yeah, we promise you give Michael his moment of glory as well. It's the last time these two met in the League Cup. Do you want to remind Scott what happened that day?
I just get all over the line. Partly we go through.
Don't move your face there.
Yeah. But I tell you, we're going into this game. Hearts going away to Celtic Park for the last victory we had. So you're not going there full of belief and hopeful. But I think today, on this Hearts side, with the squad that we've got and kind of the potential to get at Celtic, like they did at Tynecastle, just a short jump on the road there, I think this Hearts side will have a belief that they can genuinely get through to the final. And that is a big difference, a huge difference. this game was so difficult to call. You know, in the build up, it's been non stop all week. You know, who do you think is going to win? People talking about it. It's very, very difficult. These two sides, this game here today, is too tough to call. It's a great game in prospect.
A really great game, Chris. And you look at that pitch, it looks like it's a big pitch as well.
I think Celtic will be happy with the grass length. It's 50-50, and Michael's right. Every domestic trophy Brendan Rodgers has competed for, he has won. And talk about prioritising domestically over Europe wasn't for me, but you know, Brendan is going to go with his strongest side of this game. And I mean, I think it's going to be tough for Celtic. If anybody can beat Celtic, I think it's his heart team. I think they've lost once this season so far. They know how to beat Celtic. Celtic have to step up.
The drums are beginning to beat somewhere around us. Let's have a look at the teams that the respective managers have named. They both have got injury problems. Both have options available for Hearts. Ollie Lee and Peter Haring come back into the side. They both missed the game against Dundee. Mike Cochran and Callum Morrison missing out. Craig Whiting's ineligible, having played in this competition already for Dundee. Still Stephen Naismith, the talisman, and wearing the captain's armband up front today. For Celtic, Scott Bain replaces Craig Gordon in goal, as he has done in this competition. James Forrest is back from suspension. Rogic is fit. Dedrico is suspended, but at the back too. Benkovic is fit enough, and Christopher Ayers has the last five matches, and he makes a surprise return to starting lineup today. Well, Chris, let's start with Hearts. It's a slightly different midfield for Wednesday night. Peter Haring, somebody that has been so influential this season. Is it a slightly more compact midfield?
Yeah, I think so. Watching Celtic this season, they tend to struggle maybe against teams that sit back and look at my speed, so I don't know if that's what the managers think it is. I've not been involved in training, so I don't know what the team talk is. But you know, at Tynecastle, it's a small pitch, you go and get it, and you try and get in the faces. But going to Murrayfield, it's a bigger pitch, and you have to do that consideration because they don't say they have injuries all as well.
Yeah, they do have injuries, Chris, but one player is not injured, is Craig Gordon. But Brendan Rodgers has gone with Scott Bain again.
Yeah, that is a big call. And he made a mistake in the last round against St Johnston, but they nearly got back in there in the last round. I'm not sure it's the correct decision. The proof is in the pudding and how it works out. But for Celtic, key men, Rogic and Forrest, again, they're so big. And Benkovic rested on Thursday night. I didn't think that was the right decision, but Brendan wants to win domestic trophies.
You know, I think it's interesting when you look at that centre-half partnership and Christopher Ayer comes back in from Norway. He's obviously been injured, but straight back into the side. It tells you that Jack Hendry, he's not overly confident to throw him into this game. A huge game as it is. When we talk about Celtic's strongest team, that goalkeeper position will hold out that second choice. The new goalkeeper has got me. Craig Gordon is the first choice in. We'll see later on if that is going to be the right call or not.
Yeah, we will indeed. Well, it has been an interesting start to the season for Celtic. Not quite sailing as the last couple of seasons under Brendan Rodgers. Let's take a look back now at what's been a turbulent few months for the Scottish champions, both on and off the pitch.